The Keplerian elements are used to determine the shape, size and orientation of an orbit. Here we have our 6 Keplerian elements: the eccentricity, semi-major axis, inclination, right ascension of ascending node, argument of perigee and the mean anomaly. Out of these, the eccentricity is used to determine the shape of an orbit, the semi-major axis is used to determine the size of an orbit, the inclination, right ascension of ascending node and the argument of perigee. These are used to determine the orientation of an orbit. And the mean anomaly, it tells us where in the orbit is the satellite. Now these Keplerian elements can be used to find the position and velocity of the satellite. A Keplerian orbit model assumes an orbit to be elliptical, and the eccentricity of an elliptical orbit lies between 0 and 1. So, if an orbit's eccentricity is somewhere near 1, it will be highly elliptical, while if it is somewhere near 0, it will be near circular. Next in the list is the semi-major axis. To understand semi-major axis, we need to make our elliptical orbit, and here is our elliptical orbit in 2D. It will have the focus at F1 as well as at F2. Now the central body, the body around which the satellite will revolve, will lie either at F1 or at F2. For the time being, let's assume that the Earth is lying at F2. So here is our Earth lying at F2. Now here is our satellite somewhere in the orbit. Now this orbit will have a major axis, an axis passing through F1 as well as F2. So this axis is called the major axis and is denoted by 2A. Now half of this axis is what we call as the semi-major axis, denoted by A. So this is our semi-major axis.